In this video, we're going to discuss why managers love the CISSP certification, and yet a whole lot of security engineers actually hate the CISSP certification. So in this video, we're going to discuss why managers love it. We'll talk about why some engineers actually don't like it, and then we'll talk about, is this certification right for you and your goals? So I'm going to make it very clear. Managers love the CISSP certification for security professionals. And after training security professionals and security architects for decades, I can tell you that as soon as I put a CISSP on someone's resume, for the most part, as long as their resume is good, they're getting a lot of interviews and they're getting requests for the interview. So why is it? What is it that managers like about the CISSP? I'd actually say they love it. Now, we're going to talk about some perspectives of the certification, and we're also going to talk about some perspectives of the people that pass the certification. We're also going to talk about why engineers don't like it after that. So the first part of the cybersecurity certification that managers love for the CISSP is it is big, it is broad, and it is holistic. By the time you're done finishing a CISSP certification, you get the entire cybersecurity landscape. You understand things like application security, identity and access management, network security, vulnerability assessments and what they are and what they do, and pretty much building a disaster recovery plan, quantifying security, you name it, all of it. All of it at that manager or that architect level. Not the engineering level, it's more architectural related. So when they say it's a mile wide and an inch deep, it is, because a security architect or a cloud architect will have to see the big picture and the impact of one thing on another thing. Unfortunately, this is not going to teach someone how to configure a firewall, but it will talk about the types of firewalls and how firewalls work and how you what you could, should consider in your architectures. Now, the second reason managers love the CISSP is its strategic focus. So here you have a CISSP exam, which is really a security architect or a security manager exam, or a deep planning and tuning and performance optimization engineer. And it's emphasizing security architecture. It's emphasizing quantifying the organization's assets, responsibly managing risk, leading large initiatives, a creation of security policies and procedures and incident response procedures. And all of what you're trying to do is aligning things with management's goals. Well, guess what? Your manager is a planner. That's basically their job, leading, planning, and aligning. So when you actually train for the CISSP, you're training to think a lot like your manager, and you will tend to communicate like your manager, more to your manager, and managers know that and they like it because it's making you more like them. And people inherently like things that are more like themselves. So let's talk about planning and design. You know, that is one of the biggest challenges a manager has. So the better their team is at planning and designing, for the most part, the better the manager will ultimately do, delivering the right outcome. So those are some of the things you actually get out of the CISSP. Now, another really a big component of the CISSP, and this is also true of the CISM and the CCSP, is that it's vendor neutral. It's not going to bias you into thinking you should use this firewall versus that firewall versus this identity system versus another. It's going to give you enough knowledge of how these systems work that then you can evaluate the various vendors and find the best solution for your business, as opposed to getting excited and biased towards something, because we should never have any bias in security architecture. Now, there's the other reasons managers like this exam, and it tends to be the characteristics of the people that actually take the CISSP exam. So when people take the CISSP exam, the first thing you have to understand is that it's harder than most certifications. Now, it's not impossible. It's nothing like a CCIE, and I've done the CCIE and the CISSP, and I'd say this is the best value because this certification is almost as respected as the CCIE. But this is a whole lot easier than the CCIE to pass. I will also tell you that this is much harder than most. So in order to pass this exam, you're going to have to study, you're going to have to plan, you're going to have to read a little bit. And that means you're going to have some energy, enthusiasm, and passion for security to be able to get through the exam. Now, when most people want to do 10 little junior level certifications and focus on their hands-on technician skills on how to build stuff, This shows you're willing to dive deep, go above and beyond, and truly invest in yourself. And in many cases, most people need good preparation and training courses for this certification, because it's not something that you could just simply buy a practice test and take 2 days later. So that's why managers tend to like it, but let's talk about engineers and why they dislike the CISSP. Well, it's really going to depend on the two kinds of engineers. If you're dealing with planning engineers and design engineers, they typically appreciate this certification because it gives them a bigger picture that they hadn't seen before. But let's talk about those implementation engineers and those hands-on engineers that, for the most part, are either configuring firewall rules or ACL rules or adding users and IAM systems, those hands-on people. They hate the CISSP, and here's the reason why. It's an incredibly challenging exam, and there's not a single bit of hands-on anything, because the exam is a theoretical approach. It emphasizes concepts, frameworks, and best practices over the practical implementation, because it's designed for security architects who design architectures, don't build them. It's designed for security managers like the chief information security officer to understand how to run it. I know lawyers that and attorneys that are taking the CISSP to work in governance, risk, and compliance, matching their background in law and understanding law and regulations and how to work with them, and then adding the cybersecurity. So if we're dealing with these hands-on, more technician-y based implementation roles, the person's going to take the CISSP and they're going to hate it. It's going to be like that old Wendy's commercial where the woman looks inside the hamburger and can't find the hamburger and she says, "Where's the beef?" So for implementation engineers, you look at the CISSP and it's that "Where's the beef?" because it doesn't have any hands-on or how-to. So who is the CISSP really for? It's for security architects that are security planners. It's for cloud security architects that are security planners. It's for management. It's for chief information security officers. It's for security sales engineers who need to think like their clients and need to be able to sell and design the big picture. And it's for planning and design engineers. Who is the CISSP not for? Anyone whose job is mostly configuration work, especially if they're the person that configures the work and that the work was designed by an architect and engineered on what needs to be done by a deeper kind of engineer, a planning engineer. For that person who's doing implementation work all day long, assuming they want to stay in implementation work, should do more hands-on implementation type training and certifications, because it's really about what you want to do. So if I have someone that wants to be a security architect, I tell them to do the CISSP. If I have someone that wants to be a security engineer, I might tell them to get a CCNP security or a Palo Alto Networks equivalent of that, or a Fortinet equivalent like that. Because in the end, certification is a tool. It's just a tool, and like any other tool, it's a matter of selecting the right tool for the right job. So try to align your certifications with your training goals. If you have a desire to become a security architect or a cloud architect or an enterprise architect or an AI architect, please join me on a completely free webinar. We hold them weekly on Zoom. We'll go over what we do in these roles, the skills you need to get hired, and I'll answer any questions you have about your career or any of these architecture careers live for 90 minutes on Zoom after our 30-minute discussion or so. I'd love to meet you. I'd love to help you. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in another video or webinar. Take care.